working.
It's doing good. It's doing good.
I think we have to go up and down. We have to go up and down.
Yeah, yeah, we do. Cool.
Here we go. Ready for this? Ready for this? Ready for this? I'm just kidding. All right.
Okay.
So, Abby, how's everyone doing? Welcome to the Instagram Live with our host, the main man right here, Jordan J. Morello.
Hi, guys. How's it going?
So, as a lot of you guys know, we are having this live to talk about the show that I produced. I got lucky enough to be a part of, Anchors, that I will let Jordan tell you a little bit more about. I'm just going to talk about the idea of the show and how we got it and how we decided to
progress it.
Yeah, how it went from idea to now being done with the first season. Pretty cool journey there. I was in LA, right?
Yes, you were with LA.
I was in LA with Jordan. We were hanging out, and Jordan had this idea. This is something that I've always admired about Jordan, and I want to tell you guys that this is something that I want you to take from this story. Is that Jordan has a dream. He has a goal of where he wants to be and who he wants to be and how he wants to do it. So you can't just have goals. You have to have your goal and then each little step in between on the way so you can give yourself little checkpoints. And that's something that Jordan does very well. He's like, I have this goal of where I want to be. So what's one way I can progress towards that goal today? And then one thing he told me that I love is that every night before he goes to bed, he always thinks, did I make myself better today? Did I take that one step, no matter how small? Like Abraham Lincoln says, I may move slowly, but I never move backwards. So, like, Jordan did that. He came to me with an idea. He's like, I want to have, like, my own show where I talk to people, and maybe it's with working out. I don't know. I just really want to – I want to start doing that. I want to have my own show where I can meet people that inspire me and where I can move forward. And I was like, okay, cool. So him and I started to develop an idea. And then we brought in, like, the brain of every operation we're ever a part of. And Diego Rosende took a step in. And then he was like, okay, you guys have these ideas. That's great.
But let me form them.
Yeah, let me structure it into something that can actually be done. So then Diego, with his genius, comes in and creates the idea of Anchors.
Lou.
And then I'll let Jordan tell you a little bit about what it's about, what we're doing, what our goals are, and how you guys can be part of it.
So, first of all, how the show started out, do you remember when I first, like, had the idea, came to you, I was like, dude, well, first of all, you were like, you should make a show if you want to be an interviewer, if you want to be Jimmy Fallon. That's my dream, by the way, guys. I want to be a big-time host. I want to have my own television show. I want to be a host just like Jimmy Fallon. It's my big-time hero in life, and that's my goal. Big dream is out there. I'm not scared to tell anybody because I want to go for it, and whether you think I can do it or not, I'm still going to go for it. But the show started out as me going to work people out. Then I would bring them to some acai bowl place here in California and then interview them, which was a definite weird idea. And it was
okay. It was definitely weird.
It was weird. It was weird. And at first,
well, it was my idea. So it was like, no. You came with the idea and I was like, oh, we could do this. And then we both were like,
but you kept tweaking it. And then we kept, like, putting different ideas, taking things out and then putting more things in. So as it progressed, then we got the brains behind the idea, which was Diego. Diego was the man behind it. He's the backbone of this project, guys. I couldn't have done this without Diego. He is an incredible film cinematographer. He's done so many amazing projects, and honestly, he structured this project to the where it is now. So it was funny how it started, because it was just me and Alberto at first, and I had this idea, and then it formed into something bigger and bigger. And once we got to talking to Diego, he just loved the project, and he jumped on it. He went after it. So it took about a few months. They were in Greece. Go ahead.
No. Keep going.
So they were in Greece. We just kept going back and forth, talking. And then when they finally came back, I legit had no money. I went and I paid for a Toronto airfare. Literally my last probably, $350. And I said, screw it. I just want to go for it. So $350 down. Alberto became my sugar daddy for about 3 weeks, and
I'll always be your sugar daddy, baby.
Hey, what's up? And honestly, he helped us with equipment, with the connections that we needed to interview people. He helped us with food and giving us a place to stay and giving us the ideas. And I could not have done this without the two of them. So I'm very grateful for that.
But I think that's just one thing I want to touch on real quick, dude. You kind of mentioned it in like a different way, but like one of the reasons why us three work so well as best friends is because we're friends that support each other's ideas and actively build them up.
Right.
Like, that's one thing I want you guys to take note as well. Like, find friends that do that. That when you say a dream or an idea, they don't shoot you down. They say, all right, how can we help make that happen? It's right. A very important thing, I think. And absolutely. I feel like as you guys continue to make friends and whatever in your lives, you should be looking for friends that do that. Because then you get to do some great, great shit like we do.
Some cool stuff.
Yeah.
But yeah, for sure. And then it just blossomed into a really cool idea. After a few months of really tweaking it and brainstorming, and you know, we finally got out to Toronto. We lined up the people that we wanted to interview. We found some really amazing, inspirational people, and getting to know them and seeing what they're doing for their community was probably one of the most inspirational things for me, because it drove me more to make this show bigger and want to show you guys exactly what it's like to pursue your dreams at that level and really kind of motivate and inspire you guys. So I don't know if you felt that way, but
no, absolutely, absolutely. It was like it was a lot of fun. We shot. How long did it take us to shoot episode one?
Episode one, two. That was your episode, so that was what, 3 weeks?
Took us what, 4 days? 4 days, something like that. If you think about it, like you followed me over the course.
But I was there for 3 weeks, right? For all three episodes.
Yeah.
So
it was like we could say like 1 week an episode, because you had to. The way we structured it is, you know, we're going through these people's lives. You started with my life, and then we went through DW's, who I can't wait for you guys to, like, meet and hear her music, hopefully. Yeah. She's so freaking cool.
The coolest.
She's so
cool.
I wish her the best. She's actually touring the United States. She's going to be in New York City soon. It's, like, her last tour date. And then, thank God, she'll be back in Toronto to hang out with us.
Yeah.
But,
Yeah,
she's amazing. And then we got to see Isaiah's life and what he does. I think that's one of the coolest things is that you got to go through. It wasn't like a scheduled interview where it was like a day and you know you only had an hour with us. Like, you got to follow us for a whole week. So our routine was something you definitely got to understand.
Right. Right.
Which is important, I think, for our anchors.
Right. Do you want to talk about a little bit about what your anchor was for the first episode?
Yeah.
My body connection.
We'll talk about how I want you guys to watch the episode, because I bet you I answered the question so much better in the episode than I'm going to do right now. But I know that I'll say my anchor became like my fitness and boxing and working out, and how that kind of grounded me to Simon and grounded me to the professional work that I did. I talk a little bit about that in the episode. But the thing that I think was most important that I said, or the thing that I said that I didn't realize that said that I thought about a lot after was that my anchor kind of found me. I didn't go searching for it. And I think that's important. Like, a lot of people think it has to be something that you're actively doing. It can be something that you find yourself doing that holds you, or that makes you feel like, oh, I can keep, this is what keeps me motivated.
Right.
And I didn't realize I was doing it. It's just something I did every day. I think that was something that you guys should know. So it's not something that I was like, oh, I know what I like and I know what I do. No, I was just doing something.
Was that Stella?
Yeah, that was Stella. Hold on. I have to fix a painting. Jordan.
Oh, my God. So, but yeah, guys, that was probably one of the most important lines that he said. What's up, Nick? Oh, Jesus. What's up, brother? So that was probably one of the most important lines that he said in that interview, because your anchor kind of finds you. You have to find your anchor. It's not something that just, you know, it'll pop up out of nowhere and, like, you have to struggle to find it. It's something that just comes to you. So take your time in finding your anchor, and truly have a passion for it, because that's how we did. We really had a passion for something, and that's how we found our anchor. So I think that was one of the most important lines in the interview. So you'll check it out. It's in the whole interview. He talks about a lot about his anchor and how he found it. So it's really interesting how Alberto came across that.
Yeah, keep going. No, go ahead. Your anchor is more important. I was just going to do a breakdown for everyone that's, because I see some people are just starting to join. Some people are leaving. Some people are so Jordan and I and my brother Diego, we all created this show called Anchors, where Jordan is going to interview interesting, artistic, non-artistic, just interesting people that inspire us. And we're going to ask them what motivates them and what grounds them in their hunger and their motivation to do better and to continually succeed and continually push themselves to be better versions of themselves. So that's what Anchors kind of is. We thought about it because Jordan has an anchor, and he's going to talk about that. What's your anchor, Jordan?
Is that playing loud? It's loud, but
I can't hear it. So
my anchor is definitely through the gym, through fitness, through pretty much my mind-body connection, as well as Alberto. I found that at a young age because I was somebody that dealt with a lot of difficulties through school, struggling through relationships, school, and other things. And when I was 7, I was diagnosed with ADD, learning disability, and then I have Tourette's. So I was prescribed a few prescriptions to take and kind of go through my struggles of school and try to get through. And kind of, you know, the doctor wants to prescribe these medications to make you a zombie. I didn't like that feeling. So when I was 15, I remember going home and I said, "Mom, I'm done with these pills. I don't want to take this anymore. I want to feel like a normal kid. I want to go hang out with my friends after school. I want to play sports. I want to get back into basketball." And I found, you know, my mom was like, "You can't just stop cold turkey. You can't stop that drug because you're gonna, your grades are going to decline. You're going to start doing bad. You're going to start acting out." And I didn't believe that. So I started doing my research and I started seeing what would work for me. So I found the gym. I found the love. I found the passion for the gym. So I saw that, you know, the dopamine, your endorphins, everything would increase. And I would do so much better with my focus. So I started working out day after day after day. I started to get a love for it. I started to get a passion for it. I started to think and see that I could educate people on what I learned in the gym. And I can bring that knowledge to my friends, to my family. If I could help anybody in the world lose weight or even just structure their mind or get organized, whatever it was, I wanted to do that. So I became so passionate for it. And I remember I was basketball manager at St. Thomas Aquinas. And, I kept trying to make the team. And I was always pushed to the side as a manager. But there was a day where, you know, the coach was like, "You know what? You're going to be our strength and conditioning kind of coach. Like, you're the person that leads the workouts." And I was like, "Wow, that's awesome. That's something that I can definitely get behind," because it seemed like I was always injured or I wouldn't make the team. But you know what? I was there for another reason. I was there to push my teammates. I was there to push my friends. And I was there to push my family. Whether I knew it or not at the time, I didn't look at the bigger picture. I looked at, wow, I'm not making the team. I looked at the struggles. But now that I look back, I say, wow, I actually made a difference in some people's lives. And that's how I found my passion. So it continued from there on. And I give everything to my love of working out, my passion of fitness, nutrition, and eating right, to getting me through high school, through college, through all my ups and downs, my struggles. And that's what anchored me. That truly anchored me down and pushed me way, like it pushed me to excel to this point now. So that's my anchor.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
No, but that's something that's like super important, is that you had the, you wanted to change the way your life was going. So you actively did all of the things necessary to do it. You did your research. You started making the commitments and you stuck to them. You started with something that is a big part of Anchors, which you and I talk about, consistency.
Right.
Consistently every day, even the days you don't want to, you still go to the gym and you still push yourself. Those are the days that are actually more important, are the days that you're not feeling it. That you're like, oh.
You have to overcome, you know?
Exactly. It's just another obstacle that
we've been there together. Yeah.
You can get. As you guys can probably see, I really loved this idea when it came to me, and it's just clay form before it was the sculpture that it is now. And I saw a lot of opportunity with it, just to be like, wow, this inspired me to want to stick to my anchor more. If that could do that for someone else, that'd be cool.
Right.
Thank you guys for joining us in the live today. So are we going to announce when exactly Anchors is coming out?
I think so. I mean, me and Diego are probably going to do a little live on mine just to announce like when it's coming out. If anybody has any more questions, we can answer for you guys. We just wanted to give you a little backstory of exactly what Anchors is, where it came from, and how we started it. You're going to see in the episode, you're going to get all the knowledge about Alberto. You're going to step in the life of him. You're going to see what his day-to-day is and how he truly angers himself. So make sure you guys tune in. It's going to be very inspirational, very motivational, and I cannot wait for you guys to see it. So I think me and Diego will do a live, probably about 5 minutes, just check it in, see if there's any more questions, and then we're going to launch the video. So that's about it, guys.
So last thing to wrap it up. Anchors is a show where Jordan interviews interesting people that motivate him and inspire him, and he asks them what anchors them to their hunger to be better, what anchors them to that perseverance in pursuit of a better version of themselves. So thank you guys for joining. I hope you're excited to watch it. I can't wait for it to come out because I kind of forgot that I'm in the first episode. So I was just thinking from like a producer. I was like, oh, I can't wait for it to come out. We can do. Oh, crap, I'm in that one.
One more thing, watch till the end, guys, because there's a challenge at the end. So at every end of every episode, I challenge you guys to a certain thing. You have to watch the end. I'm not going to tell you what the challenge is, but it's a challenge for the week. And I give you a hashtag. That way you can hashtag us, and we can see if you're coming through with the anchors. So we want to challenge you guys for the week, see if you can do it, and that's it. So just watch till the end. So that's it.
All right, guys.
Two thumbs up.
Two thumbs up, man. Two thumbs up. Yeah. So thank you guys so much for joining. Jordan and I are going to keep getting everything ready. And we will both tweet when the trailer is going to drop so that you guys can check it out immediately.
Well, I'll share it with everyone.
and I'll retweet it. Let us know what you think. Please give us your feedback. Share it with your friends, your family, people that you think it might inspire. Remember, one of my favorite quotes is the student goes to the master and he goes, "Master, I'm uninspired. We've been doing this every day and I no longer want to. How do I get inspired?" And then the master says, "Inspire others." So if this inspires you, see if it'll inspire someone else that you think can push themselves, or someone that you think needs the help, or just anyone that you want to show this. Like, this is a show that we definitely want people to see. We feel like with its positivity and what it's offering, I really like what our show says, and I think you guys should have people check it out.
Absolutely. And guys, again, I just want to say thank you for all your support and love. It means the world to us. Seriously, it's amazing to see that we have a lot of fans and a lot of supporters of this, because it's something that I really believe in wholeheartedly. So again, thank you guys.
All right.
On that note, we're out.
Let you guys go. Peace, guys.